there. Mark Oldman coming at you, not only from the house where I grew up, but from the room where I grew up. To prove it, check this out. This can only be the work of a 13-year-old New Jersey boy. That's what we do. We put stickers on doors. I don't know why. But anyway, I'm here to tell you about old wine, that is mature wine, and how special it can be. And there is still a wine fridge, my original wine refrigerator, in the room where I grew up. So I'm about to show it to you and show you a very special wine in there. Come with me. Ah, great memories of Caddyshack, one of the best movies ever. So not only did I have a poster of Caddyshack up on my wall, but here, when I was just old enough to drink, I put in my very first wine fridge. And conveniently, it came with a lock, so my older sister couldn't get in and bogart my bottles. So I have the key to the lock, and here we go. Open it up. Impenetrable lock, or so I liked to think. And here they are, the original wines I collected. And when I was in college, I discovered the Hess collection. It was very early in the life of the Hess collection, and I thought these were great, big, rich, plummy California Cabernets. And they still are. And let's see, if I remember correctly, this is one of the prized bottles. This is a 1987 Hess collection Cabernet Sauvignon. It was so amazing, and even as a college student, I knew, you know what, I want to lay this down and have it mature and then one day drink it. So I think it's time. Okay, so here in my dad's study, final phase of the mature wine lesson here. So I've got my Hess 87 Cabernet. Very nostalgic for it. The first bottle of wine I've ever collected, or I ever collected in college. We pour it. The first thing you notice, it's not that kind of ruby with a purpley rim. It's actually kind of a brickish red. And that's the sign of an older wine. After about 10 years, 15 years, a red wine will take on almost a brown ruby color, kind of a brickish color. Then you smell it. Let's see. I have no idea. Oh, wow. I remember that this wine started with kind of bright fruits and an intense plumminess, and I still get that, but I also get kind of secondary smells, like licorice, and a kind of really pleasant, like, leathery quality to it, a Hermes quality, if you will, like a smelling just great kind of treated leather. And then you taste it. Mmm. That is smooth. Unbelievably smooth. And that's the way it should be with good, mature wine. That as wine ages, sometimes a tannic Cabernet Sauvignon will start with, you know, this kind of tannic astringency, but over the years, hopefully, and you never know, but hopefully that kind of gum-numbing tannin will smooth out. And these secondary flavors, it could be licorice, it could be mushrooms, it could be kind of an autumn leaf pile, but those will come out in the nose and then in the taste. And I'll tell you, you know, Hess has gotten more expensive over the years, but it's still a good value. When I bought this, it was $18. And that goes to show that not all ageable wine, age-worthy wine, that is wine that improves with age. Remember, it's only 2% in the world, approximately. Not all of it's expensive. So if you go to your local wine store and you say, what's a good older wine? If you don't want to have to get your own wine fridge and age it yourself. Say, you know, what do you have on hand with a little bit of age? Because I want to kind of try that out and experiment with it and kind of experience new taste sensations. But then also, it's fun to get a certain year commemorating, you know, a birth year, for example. It's just a really great way of celebrating life's anniversaries. I'm Mark Oldman, coming at you from the house where I grew up, in the Jersey, telling you, reminding you, please, poosh it.